Well, reconciling, you first have a difference in terms of where you have to reconcile. And that depends how you set it up. If you have, for example, full stakeholder involvement in setting up a nuclear power program, in the site selection and so on, then the differences may not be that marked that you would have to reconcile. If you missed out on that, then of course you can have issues where people feel equity or disequity, simply that they say we have the burden of a nuclear power plant in our backyard, while the rest of the country reaps the benefits through cheap electricity and all that. There, of course, the regional or local benefits then have to be stressed. The jobs, the overall better infrastructure, the higher tax income, and all these things are ways where you then say, look, yes, you have a burden, or at least perceived burden, of a nuclear power plant, but here are also the benefits. So you really have to look how you possibly can balance these equities, if there are inequities, if they exist. But they can, in my view, in my experience, be avoided by a transparent approach to nuclear power. Again, Europe is not a homogeneous entity, and different countries have taken different approaches, some more successful than others. I mean, if you look at the current situation, the United Kingdom has a relatively high approval rate compared to the rest of Europe on nuclear power. Why? Well, they have basically gone through a full cycle of all options. They had their coal, then they had oil and gas, now the North Sea reserves are getting increasingly depleted. They have tried aggressively, really, with public and policy support into renewables, wind, and so on. And all has not really led to a situation where they say, our energy security is on a safe track and we can combat climate change. So with that knowledge and that debate, politically and also with the public, then you get a high approval rate in terms of, okay, we may not like it, but that is basically the reality we have to face, and so let's go with it. Look at Finland. Again, quite transparent way of dealing with the issue. Long-term thinking from the government, not just until the next election. In Finland, they tied the decision to build the fifth reactor, which is in the construction right now, with the waste disposal. So the approval was basically tied to a site selection for a waste repository for spent fuel. Sweden has a similar situation. So it really depends how you look at it, what you can learn. And as I said already in your first question, transparency, stakeholder involvement. Get the facts out, make people understand why the country needs nuclear power. Do an extensive energy analysis and planning for the next 20, 30, 40 years into the future. Go through all options. Make this process transparent and participatory. So people can come with their own assumptions about demand, about energy intensities, resource availability, and all that. And you can really play. In that interaction, you come, you define a solution space where you say, well, as long as we stay within these boundaries, nuclear power makes sense. If you're outside, well, then the situation is different. But this is something where people have the confidence that they understand what's happening, and this decision-making is not just a black box. Well, the main impacts are energy security. And of course, in the long run, climate change. These are the main impacts. You have still galloping energy demand, electricity demand, in most countries. You will also, in some countries, have a water problem. So desalination may be one of the services that could be supplied by nuclear energy. I think these are the main thing: energy security and climate change. Diversification is part of energy security, so even there is an argument, and of course also spin-offs. If you look at the economic benefits of a countries that started nuclear power some 40, 50 years ago, like South Korea. Right now, 50% of the benefits are not from nuclear power construction and operation, but through all the technologies, nuclear application technologies, from radioisotopes, health, quality control, and so on. So it's also this aspect that has a socioeconomic impact beyond just the nuclear power application. Other things that come to mind is, of course, it is a high-tech, complex technology where the jobs require a certain level of education. So in one way, the nuclear power lifts the overall standard of education. Simply, it's a requirement, so it will lead to that situation that you have a better educated overall environment or population.